Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.2 still has quite a few issues, but it's better than before. I wanted to talk about that, as well as when to expect maybe the next version, iOS 15.2.1, 15.3 Beta 2, and more. So as we move into getting back on track with iOS updates and beta releases, I do expect some sort of release this coming week as far as the beta goes. However, we might see a new iOS update version for the public. And the reason I say that is it looks like we could use an iOS 15.2.1 if 15.3 is not ready. There's notable issues with it. From HomeKit, so if you have HomeKit, you're using HomeKit, there can be some major issues with it if you rename a device to over 500,000 characters. I don't know who's doing this, but a security researcher found this, and it will trigger a bug making the device unusable even after a restore. So that's something to note. Also, Messages was found to be sending read receipts even with that option turned off. Noise cancellation still needs to come back to the 13 series devices. And also, there's that music bug we've had forever, which seems to be an issue where if you're streaming music, it just uses a ton of battery. And you'll see I'm kind of in the middle of nowhere, so it takes a moment to load. But those are all things that need to be addressed, not only for security, but overall stability. So I expect Apple to address those. Now, maybe they'll wait until iOS 15.3, but 15.2.1 could be this week or next, depending on what they decide to do. So with those things in mind, if we don't see a 15.3 really soon, I would expect some sort of small update in between. Now, as far as iOS 15.2 overall, this is my 12 Pro Max, so I've been running the latest public versions on this, and let's make sure we're at full brightness outside here. In 15.2, there's still some notable issues. With the iPhone 12 and 13 series, people are still reporting green tint. Now on the 13, I've started to see this more, and I've actually noticed it myself on my device and my wife's device from time to time. So I'm really hoping Apple can address this via software, at least on the 13 series, but they never addressed it with the 12 series devices. So we may have to wait and see as far as that goes. Now, as far as iOS 15.2, there's a lot of good things to really mention about this. It's much more stable than previous versions. It seems to be very smooth as far as performance, no really big complaints there. And it has better battery than previous versions of iOS 15. However, lately, that doesn't seem to be true. We'll talk more about that in just a moment. Now, with iOS 15.2, it seemed to fix issues I had with iOS 15 as far as 5G connectivity, switching between cellular, Wi-Fi, LTE, 5G, things like that. But then with 15.3, those issues came back since it reverted to an older modem update. So that seemed to be an issue for me. However, 15.2 still has some bugs that need to be addressed. There's some odd battery drain bugs. So if you're having battery issues, you're not alone. There's a lot of comments on the YouTube community poll. I went back and looked at them, and we'll take a look at those in a moment. But there's still a lot of odd battery drain bugs, probably from that music bug I mentioned before. There's that storage bug where storage could be reported incorrectly, so we'll go into general, and apparently there's a touch bug, although it's kind of cold outside, so maybe that's why. It loaded pretty quickly for me, but there's still a storage bug for some. Also, there's CarPlay issues. Those are never-ending CarPlay issues, it seems, with iOS 15. So all of those issues need to be addressed, as well as some odd Bluetooth bugs here and there, although most of those seem to be better with switching between maybe your AirPods, between your Mac, and things like that. Those seem to be much, much better with this particular update. Now, as far as iOS 15.3, Beta 1 has been quite stable. It's fixed most bugs, other than that cellular issue I mentioned before. When switching between 5G, 5G UC, back to LTE, it has all sorts of issues where in order to fix that, I need to turn on airplane mode, turn it back off, and that resolves the issue for me. It's still a continual issue for me on this update. Battery has been okay, and battery on this device, let me go back here as I was adjusting the brightness levels for outside. Battery on this device, battery health is at 100%, and my battery life overall has been okay. I'll go to bed with about 50%, and let's go to yesterday. Now let's go to a day I used a ton of battery. I had 5 hours and 43 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 42 minutes of screen off time, and used about 90%. Now that's not really in the range of what you should be getting, and that's because of that music bug. You can see there's that background activity, and depending on the day, it really varies greatly. So sometimes I'll get really great battery life, but still I'm going to bed most evenings with about 50% left. This really should be fixed, hopefully in the next beta and when 15.3 releases to the public. The overall battery continues to be a problem on my iPad though. So with battery life on the iPad, again, it seems to be an issue. Everything else has been quite stable on this update. So battery life, we'll go into battery, the last 10 days. You can see here, 2 hours and 11 minutes, the day before that, 2 hours. And there's some screen off time as well, which doesn't make sense because I'm not using this with the screen off ever with music or anything like that. And I charged it to 77% 2 hours ago. We're down to 68%. So with very little use, it seems to be draining quickly. I want that 10 hours of battery life back, but it's still something that we haven't seen for quite some time with these beta updates. Public releases, sometimes it comes and goes, but overall it seems to be good other than that battery life. Now, based on past releases, I would expect iOS 15.3 beta 2 this coming week. Typically in the second or so week of January is when Apple is back after the holiday vacation and they're starting to work on these things again. So as soon as maybe Monday or Tuesday or as late as Thursday. But I would expect some sort of beta release this week, if not a public release as well. Apple last year released some iOS 12 updates as well during that week. So we could see a bunch of different updates, not just for iPhone, but iPad, maybe Mac as well. So I'm looking forward to those. But based on what we've seen in the past 3 years, I would expect an update this week to at least beta 2. And last year we only had a couple betas, then a release candidate, and a final release at the end of the month. And I would expect that, since I've mentioned before that we do expect the Apple Digital ID to be showing up, at least for use in some airports in the United States, in February at some point, according to Apple working with the TSA to get that done. So I would expect something along those lines. Now, as far as the community poll and comments, I thought we'd take a look at just a few of them, since quite a few of you keep commenting on that. So I went back and looked at the YouTube community poll, and there's 26,000 votes on the 15.3 Beta 1 community poll, and on the 15.2 community poll there's 33,000 votes, with quite a few of you continuing to comment on 15.2. So there's 702 comments here. If we go to the latest comments, you'll see that people are still commenting on it as recent as a couple days ago, where they say the storage bug remains. Could you please test on 11 Pro and Pro Max? It does not seem to be device dependent. It seems to be an overall issue with this. Also, you'll see quite a few people mentioning battery life again. Battery life on iOS 15 has not been good for me since the launch. I'm using iPhone XR. Again, there's more and more people commenting on battery as time goes on. You'll see here, Next Level YE says, "Hey there, Aaron, I just updated my iPhone SE 2020 from iOS 14.3 to iOS 15.2. Big leap, I know. So far, my iOS 15 experience on this phone has been decent, but far from perfect. Performance is pretty similar to iOS 14. I've experienced lots of new bugs in this release. Safari in particular has been very buggy, especially when switching between portrait and landscape orientation. I have also observed that the camera and photos app crash when using speak selections to speak live text within a photo or within the camera feed. I would report these bugs in the feedback app, but I don't currently have access to the app since I'm not using a beta build of iOS. It's too soon to tell whether battery life has been better or worse than iOS 15 compared to iOS 14. Love the content, keep up the good work." And thank you. So with that said, there's definitely some issues with it, especially if you're coming from 14 to 15. Like I've said many times, performance seems to be about the same or better. Battery life can be hit or miss depending on who you are. However, there's exceptions to all of these, and you'll see here, iPadOS 15.2, battery life is really awesome, even better than iPadOS 15.1. So it really just depends on what device you're using, what apps you use, and more. And then for 15.2, you'll see Maddie Ross said, "It appears that 15.2 address the battery drain I've been experiencing from 15.1.1. No issues so far and pretty stable in general using the 13 Pro. And it really varies from person to person and device to device, but most people recently in these comments, if you go back and look at them, are having issues with particular issues such as battery and more. Patricia says, "I got my new iPhone 13 Pro 4 days ago, started using it after 1 day with iOS 15.2, waited for my case and screen protector to come. I upgraded from the iPhone 6S, which was almost 4 years old, this coming May. My problem for this new phone are heating issues whenever I charge it since I got it, using Apple's 20-watt power adapter and the included cable in the box, and battery life draining a bit too fast considering it is a new phone. First 3 days of usage of my new phone was great, and then on the fourth day my battery drops quite a bit despite not being in use, in comparison to the first 3 days where they didn't experience any battery drop when the phone is not in use, together with the faster battery drain when the screen is on. A bit disappointed, so hopefully it will get sorted out on the new update, which I'm also hopeful will be soon enough. Couple things to note here. I wouldn't worry about the phone getting warm when charging. You're using the 20 watt adapter, which is actually a fast charger, and it will get a bit warm. It's completely normal, and the iPhone manages it itself. So I really wouldn't worry about that. It's completely normal for batteries to warm up when you're charging them. As long as it's not super hot to where it would burn you, it should be fine. Again, you'll see a similar situation where I'm using an iPhone 13 Pro Max and have been noticing for the past 3 days that the battery is draining quickly. The iOS is updated to 15.2, and this was updated at least 10 to 12 days back. Yesterday, the screen on time was 5 hours and 27 minutes and off time of 48 minutes. Battery usage was 50%. If I go back 10 days, screen on time was 4 hours and 42 minutes, and off time was 1 hour and 7 minutes with battery usage at 40%. Should I be concerned? No, that's better than most people will get, so I wouldn't be concerned with that at all. It seems to be doing quite well. And most people here are commenting about 15.2, but you'll see iOS 15.2 on iPhone 13 storage is showing different numbers when I connect it with my PC. So there continues to be issues, and hopefully Apple updates this very soon, like I said, with a 15.2.1, or we get 15.3 within the next couple weeks. I would love to see that. Now, if you've had any other issues or you've found any other new features or anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.